Today concept name is overriding. Today concept name is overriding. Very, very important concept, overriding. Overriding and interface. Using these two concepts, we can enter into Selenium. Tomorrow onwards, we can enter into Selenium. So today concept is very, very important. Just concentrate. Using this syntax only, we can work with Selenium. So only for this concept, we learned Java. Only one concept. Only one concept. That concept name is overriding. Overriding and interface. Overriding. What is overriding? If at all, a function existing in parent class then that function if we write in child class then that concept is called overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, same function, if you write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. Whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. In child class extra, if you want any functions, you can write it. That parent class function should be there in child class. That is the concept of override. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called override. Whatever we have, parent class function should be there in child class.
That is small doubt. So if the function exists in parent class, then that function if you write in parent class, that is not overriding. So why would you write in child class? We can call from child class, right? We can call the child class. Our function in child class is called to the right to the class.
I will tell you. If at all a function existing in one class, same function if you write in another class, same function if you write in another class, then that concept is called overriding. Whatever we have, parent class function should be there in child class. Child class, if you want any extra function, you can write it. That parent class function should be there in child class, then we can say it is a overriding. Function overriding. Function overriding. Function, it will be overriding. Whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. In child class, if you want extra function, you can write it. That parent class function should be there in child class. Then we can say overriding. Or some faculties, they will tell like, if at all a function existing in one class, then the same function if you write in another class, then the concept is called overriding. If at all a function existing in one class, then that function, if you write in another class, then that concept is called override. Okay? Right. Whatever we have in parent class, function should be there in child class. In child class, if you want extra function, you can write it. In child class, if you want any extra functions, you can write it. That parent class function should be there in child class. The parent class function should be there in child class. That is the concept of overriding. Right. Go to. go to SRC, take the new class over, keep the mark, not over, just I am taking class name is model 1, click on finish. I am taking one class model 1. I am writing functions. I am not taking any main method. Public void non-static functions I am writing. Public void call. SYSO control space. Model 1 call. Model 1 reject. Model 1 message. Three functions I am writing. Model 1 call, model 1 message, model 1 reject. Okay? Right. See. I am taking another class. Go to SRC. Take the new class. Model 2. Click on finish. Model 2 call, model 2 reject, model 2 message. Public void WhatsApp. Model to WhatsApp. So whatever we have, parent class function should be there in child class. So here we have child class. So whatever we have, call, reject, message. We have three functions. Extra functions you can write it. Go WhatsApp. I wrote WhatsApp. Share. Now I want to call from another class. How we can call? Take the new class over. I want to call from model 1 class functions. So model 1 m1 equal to new model 1. Model 1 m1 equal to new model 1 m1 dot call m1 dot message m1 dot reject I want to call model 2 functions. How we can call model 2 m2 equal to new model 2.
New model 2. Same m2 dot call, m2 dot reject, m2 dot
call. M2 dot call. M2 dot reject. M2 dot WhatsApp. into dot WhatsApp. This is the concept of overriding. Today concept is, main concept is interface. What is interface? For example, we have iPhone. So in iPhone we have different models, like model 1, model 3, model 4, iPhone 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s, 7s, 8s, 9s. Okay, we have different models. But finally, iPhone people decided they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. They decided, so if they want to introduce any model into market, they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. So that is the reason they decided they want to maintain some common features. So first of all, they are creating one interface. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they will install this common functions or interface functions. After that, if they want any feature, they can add it. iPhone people finally decided they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. That's the reason they are creating one interface. In the interface, they are keeping some common functions. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they will install that interface function. After that, if they want any extra function, they can add it. But compulsory, they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. That is the reason they are creating one interface, and they are keeping the interface functions. They are keeping some functions in interface. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they will install that interface functions. After that, if they want any extra function, they can add it. But they want to maintain some common functions in each and every model. Okay. First, they are creating one interface. What is interface? Interface is something created between two something. In between two somethings, I'm keeping something, so that is called interface. Right. First of all, we need to create the interface. How to create the interface? Same to same. How to take the class, go to SRC, take the new interface. Same, in the place of class, I am taking interface. Interface name iPhone, I am taking. Click on finish. Here I am writing, I want to maintain some common functions in each and every model. So now I am taking interface functions. Public void call. Public void message. Public void reject. C three functions I want to maintain commonly. So that is the reason I am creating on an interface. I am keeping it here. Alright. Model one. I'm taking one interface, so I'm keeping the functions. Now, each and every model having this interface functions or not, I want to check. Each and every model having this interface functions or not, I want to check. Each and every model having interface functions or not, I want to check. So, actually, in the model one and the model two, I wrote only three functions only. But iPhone having thousands of functions. If you want check manually, it is very difficult. Each and every model having this interface functions are not, we know. So we will use this interface concept. So model one implements iPhone. Yes, there is no error. That means whatever we have in interface functions here available. So that is the reason it is not showing an error. So if it is an interface function missing, automatically it will show error. See. So it is showing error. Right? Huh? Control. Model 2 having interface functions are not, I want to check. Model 2 having interface functions are not, I want to check. Model 2 implements iPhone. Here also it is not showing any error. Whatever we have in interface function should be here. Yes, available. So that's the reason it is not showing any error. Right. Now we will learn only one line. This line purpose we learn Java. That line is interface name, reference name, equal to new class. Interface name, reference name, equal to new class name. Only for this line purpose we learned Java, entire Java. What is the use? Only this line. Interface name, reference name, equal to new class name. Here interface is iPhone. I equal to new class name, model 1 or model 2, whatever you want you can take it. Model 1, new model 1. Okay, i.call you can get, i.message you can get, i.reject you can get. I want to call model 2 functions. iPhone i1 equal to new model. i1 dot call i1 dot message, i1 dot reject. Right. i1 dot WhatsApp. We can get or not? i1 dot WhatsApp. It's not coming. Why? Whatever we have interface functions, so through interface reference we can call only interface functions only. We can call only interface functions only. Through class reference we can call the all the class functions, but interface functions only, whatever we have in interface, only interface functions only we can get it. That is the concept of interface. So only interface functions only we can get here. Only this line purpose we learn Java interface name reference name equal to new class. Interface name reference name equal to new class name, that is the line, only for line.